Good morning, everybody. All right, guys, we're going to get started. So today we've got a little bit of a run row. We've got three blocks. It's going to be about 38 minutes of work, maybe a little bit less. And then let's see, 28 minutes of work. And then we'll do a little stretch in the beginning, stretch at the end, get you guys out of here. We've got a little bit of a run row. I'm going to share the screen for only one block today. That block is long. It's 12 minutes long. We've got varying rep counts as you guys are going through. So take breaks when you guys need to and hop right back into it. Grab yourselves a set of medium or heavy weights. If you have them already, great. We're going to be doing some deadlifts to low rows and then some hammer curls to front squats. So grab something that you guys can do those with. If you need to go grab something heavier, go ahead and do so. Make sure you got some water with you because we are just going to keep on going. There is a lot of cardio-based exercises today. We're not really stopping all the way through aside from me to demo. So we're going to get started. We got our standard 5-minute warm-up. We're going to be doing cobra swings, T-spine rotations, dynamic ankle mobilization, isometric hold, bird dog, and then bear planks with shoulder taps. So for our cobra swings, we're going to be on our mats, on our stomachs, on our mats. You're going to start with your hands right on your butt crossed. You're going to lift up so your chest is off the ground. Squeeze your shoulder blades together, and you're going to come out to full extension and then back as you squeeze your shoulder blades together. Then you'll come back down to the ground. We've got 1 minute of that. Then we've got our T-spine rotations. You'll still be on your mat. You're going to have your arms stacked directly underneath your shoulders, and you're going to rotate till that elbow is down to the ground. We've got 30 seconds for that on each side. Then we have our dynamic ankle mobilization. We're going to be in our downward dog, and we're just going to make sure that we are getting a good little ankle stretch in. We got 30 seconds on each side there. Then our isometric hold bird dog. We're just going to hold that bird dog for 30 seconds, trying to get the full extension. So when you're trying to get the full extension, push your heels, not your toes, push your heels toward the wall behind you and try and get your fingertips pointed as straight as possible. That's going to help you keep your body in that straight line as you're doing that. Then we have our bear plank with alternating shoulder taps. So we're going to be in our bear plank position. Knees are going to hover slightly off the ground. We're going to try and make sure that our whole body doesn't move. So if you need to go a little bit wider in your stance on both your hands and your toes, you're going to go ahead and do that. We'll be there for a minute for that exercise. We got 5 minutes to get started. We're going to go ahead, get ourselves started with our cobra swing. Guys, I'm back in my garage too. No more outside workouts, trucks passing by. This is a great feeling today. So we're gonna get started with those cobra swings. We're down on the ground in 3, 2, 1. We got a minute of cobra swings. We got about 20 seconds left. And we're going to go into our T-spine rotations. Rotate up to your knees. Right over the left, go into our bird dog, drop that knee down towards the ground, stretch it out. Switch sides. And 3, 2, 1, we're going into isometric bird dog hold. Remember, push your heels towards the wall behind you, straighten your fingers. Keep on working. 3, 2, 1, we're switching sides. One, our bear plank with shoulder taps. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. Our last warm up. We got about 20 seconds left. Keep on working. We're going to shut it down in 3, 2, 1. Shut it down. We'll get into our first block. So our first block, gonna be 9 minutes long. We're doing 3 rounds. I'm gonna time you guys through. We're gonna start with a power jack. We're doing a minute of power jacks. We're gonna go directly into a deadlift to low row. So we're gonna go run row, run row, run row. So power jack first, deadlift to low row, 3-step lateral sprint, hammer curl to front squat. So the deadlift to low row, the hammer curl to front squat should allow you guys to let your heart rate drop a little bit before we get back into the power jacks and the 3-step lateral sprint. So for the power jacks, you're gonna grab a weight, something light if you can. Otherwise, we're just gonna do them without the weights, with body weight. Power jacks, we're gonna shoot the weight up, kick our feet out. We'll be there for a minute. Then we're gonna go into our deadlift to low row. So feet shoulder width distance apart. You're gonna have a soft bend in your knees. Those weights are gonna trace right down your thighs. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Once you get down until you feel that stretch in your hamstrings, you're gonna rotate those weights, bring the elbows to your rib cages, back down, rotate palms towards your legs, squeeze your butt on the way up. Keep your core tight. Then we're doing our 3-step lateral sprints. That inside knee should be up so that you can jump right off to go to the other side. Then we have our hammer curl to front squat. So grab your weights. Palms are going to be facing each other. You're going to come up into your hammer curl, rotate your weights into the front squat, drop into your front squat, rotate out, slowly lower back in. We've got a minute of the first two exercises, 30 seconds of the lateral sprint and hammer curl to front press, or front squat, I mean. We're gonna get started. Starting with that power jack, grab your weights. We're getting started. 3, 2, 1, let's go. Thank you. There we go. Keep on moving. 10 more seconds. In 3, 2, 1, we're going to that deadlift to low row. Make sure when you're coming up from your deadlift that your chest is leading. We're going to get one more rep in 3, 2, 1. We're going to that 3-step lateral sprint. Let's do it. We only have 30 seconds of these. Less than 10 seconds to go right here. Keep on moving. We're going hammer curl front squat. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. Alright guys, right back into our power checks, our second round right now. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. We got 10 seconds to go right here. Don't stop now. That heart rate will come down next. We're switching it up in 3, 2, 1, deadlift to low row. We got 15 seconds to go, guys. There we go. We're going into that 3-step lateral sprint in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. We got 30 seconds right there. All right, guys, hammer curl to front squat. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. Yeah. guys, starting round three. This is our final round. Going back into power jacks in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. Our final round right here. There we go, way to keep on moving. We got 10 seconds left. There we go. We're going into those deadlifts to low rows. 3, 2, 1. Final round, deadlifts to low rows. Never told you. 15 seconds to go. There we go. All right, drop your weights. We're going 3-step lateral sprint. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. We only have less than a minute of work left. Come on, we got 10 seconds to go. There we go. We shut it down in 3, 2, 1. Take a breather, shut it down. All right, guys, so this is our long block coming up right now. 12-minute block. We've got hip bridge, pop jacks, static lunges, froggers, sumo squats, speed skaters. So, our hip bridge, we're gonna be laying down on our mats, heels dug into the ground. You're gonna squeeze your butt until you get yourself to a straight line. You guys wanna stack a weight right on your pelvis, feel free to do so. You're gonna squeeze and hold for a one count before you lower back down. Then, we're going into our pop jacks. You guys are like me, you have tight hips. I like to stack my dumbbells on the ground so I can use those as my hand rest. Allows me to elevate my hips, allows me to jump up and land my feet flat on the ground. If you guys are landing on your toes, try and do something like with an elevated hand motion so that you can get your heels to land on the ground. So we're gonna be in our pop jacks. You're just gonna be down, pop up, back down, pop up. Option here is to step in, step out. Then we've got our static lunges. You're gonna hold into this lunge right here and you're just gonna pulse up and down. You've got 10 on each side. Then we're going into our froggers. Feet are gonna be wide, toes are gonna be pointed out, wider than shoulder stance. You're gonna come down with your hands and jump up. We're not jumping today. We're going into a nice little calf raise and hold here. Don't worry about getting your hands all the way to the ground.
I'd rather you guys keep your chest up and eyes forward than bend over and try and reach the ground with your fingers. Then we've got our sumo squat. You guys want to grab some dumbbells right here. Feet are going to be in that same frogger position, out wide, toes pointed outwards. You're going to come down into your sumo squat. Again, don't worry so much about your range of motion. More worried about your chest up, your eyes forward, so that you're not bending over. Really feel that in your butt, in your thighs, and in your quads. Then we've got our speed skaters. You're going to try and cover the distance of your mat and balance on one foot here. As the option, you're going to step and balance, step and balance. We've got 12 minutes right here. I'm going to share the screen. You guys are going to be on your own time, your own rep counts. We're going to get going in 3, 2, 1. Let's do it. On those static ones, if you guys want to grab a weight, hold it like a goblet, feel free to.
Get the jiggy with it.
He has a good goal right here. See if you can get all the way through your speed skaters before you take your first break. Good job, guys. Way to keep on moving.
We're 5 minutes in. We're almost halfway through.
Won't work out? Oh, come on, get some progress in. Thank you.
In Vegas, yeah, I drink it, good for business. Get serenaded by ladies, basically naked. It's crazy, this life I take you, yeah. Everybody,
all the
white girls, drink my personas. Checking out to get you pumping, to keep the shots on the tape. And stand up heavy, the way you look to the ground. When I'm fading all my tension and timing. But keep on getting persuaded that I want it. Drag the chain to stand, invite all your lady friends. Tell that bartender, serve a motherfucking round of gins. Tell that bartender, make the motherfuckers stronger. I wanna go all day long.
Come on, guys, we're 10 minutes in. We got 2 minutes to go. Don't stop now. Guys, we got 90 seconds left. This is our second last block. Don't stop now. Guys, we're under a minute. I want everybody to keep on working for the next 45 seconds. Guys, 10 seconds to go here. Don't stop now. Follow through with all those 10 seconds. We shut it down in 3, 2, 1. Shut it down. Take a breather. Woo! Grab yourselves a little bit of water. We're going to get on to our final block. Our final block, guys, is going to be all core. We got 7 minutes, 30 seconds each exercise. We'll get a little bit of a 30-second rest at the end of the block. We got 2 rounds, 3 minutes of work each time. We're going to start with our crunch to alternating heel touch. So we're going to be on our mats. You're going to be in your static crunch. So your shoulders off the ground, eyes pointed up at the ceiling, and you're going to rotate and touch your heels. Then we're gonna go into a static boat hold. So legs are gonna be parallel to the ground. Arms are gonna be with your legs. You're making nice train tracks here. Parallel, roll your shoulders back and down. Holding that for 30 seconds. Then we're going into a sprinter sit up for 30 seconds. Followed by one more boat hold. Marco, you can go back there if you need to. Boat hold. And then we're going into a leg raise. So hands are going to be pushing into the ground. You're going to lift your heels up towards the ceiling here. And then we're going back into a boat hold. And then into a cobra stretch. Go ahead, Els. All right, guys. We got 7 minutes of work left. And then you guys are done and out. We're going to start that crunch to alternating heel touch. In 3, 2, 1, we got 30 seconds each exercise.
Oh,
5 seconds to go, guys. We're going right into that boat hold next. Boat hold in 3, 2, 1, let's do it. We got 10 seconds left here. Sprinter sit ups next. Sprinter sit ups in 3, 2, 1, let's do it. 30 seconds here. Less than 10 seconds to go. We'll go right back into that boat hold. We got boat holds in 3, 2, 1, boat hold. Keep your hands up, your legs up. Don't let your boat sink. Seconds, hold on to it. Don't stop now, don't let it go. Three, two, one, leg raises. There we go. We got a couple seconds left in 3, 2, 1, back into that boat hold. We'll get a little bit of a reprieve right after this. Seconds left the boat hold. We'll do a little cobra and stretch it out for 30 seconds. Less than 10, hold on to it. We're gonna flip over on our stomachs in 3, 2, 1, stretch it out for a little bit. 30 seconds stretch, we got one more block. One more round of this. Guys, we got round two. We're going back into that crunch to alternating heel touch in 3, 2, 1. This is our final round right here. Let's get after it. Let's see if we can make it all the way through this final round. Your core is gonna burn. Embrace that burn. Boat hold in 3, 2, 1. If you guys need to rest for a second, put your hands behind your thighs. Allow yourself to rest. Get it back into it. We got sprinter sit ups coming up in 3, 2, 1. Sprinter sit up. Genesis, when I was dead broke, man, I couldn't picture this. 50 inch screen, money green, leather sofa, not too
sing with the soap blues.
Guys, we got less than 10 seconds right here. Going into the leg raise. 3, 2, 1, let's do it. If you guys are tired, just go ahead and hover your feet off the ground. Hold it there, that iso leg raise hold. Less than 10 seconds, we got another photo coming up next. That's our last one.
And if you don't know, now you know.
Last photo hold, 3, 2, 1, let's do it.
And if you don't know, now you know.
Guys, we're not stopping now, we got 30 seconds left. This is where changes are made right here. Convince yourself to keep on pushing through that pain. In 3, 2, 1, woo! Flip on over to that cobra. Now move it back into a child's pose. All right, guys, you guys are done. What a killer block. We'll do a little bit of a stretch right now, and then we'll get you guys out of here. What a killer finisher block right there. We're gonna go into a standing quad stretch. And we'll switch sides. Now we're gonna get a little bit of a hamstring and calf stretch. If you guys still have your dumbbell out, rest your foot on your one of your dumbbells. Heels on the ground, toes on the dumbbell. Back foot, soft bend. You're gonna hinge at your waist till you feel that stretch. And we're gonna switch sides. All right, now we're gonna sit down on our mats. You're gonna cross one leg behind you, one leg in front of you. We're gonna lean forward. Now we're gonna rotate back. Switch legs. Whatever leg was in back, you're going to move to the front. Whatever in front's going to the back. We're going to lean forward.
And I'll be talking. Yeah, I knew I'm moving.
Now we're gonna lean back. And then one final stretch, we're gonna pop up. Feet are gonna be wide, toes pointed forward. You're gonna have a soft bend in your left leg, straight right leg. You're gonna try and reach down to the back of your heel of your left foot. You should feel this in your hip flexor and in your thigh, inner thighs of that standing straight leg. And then we're just gonna walk our hands over, straighten that left leg, soft bend in that right leg. All right, guys, you guys are good to go. All done, happy Wednesday. Come join me for Pizza Pie Wednesday. I did vegan last week, so this week, naturally, we're doing all meat. Meat lovers pizza today. I'll see you guys later. Happy Wednesday.
Thanks, Brett. Bye.